Hello, my name's Hayley Moyle. I'm from Hillstone Primary School and we're part of the Ogden Trust Pilot Partnership. I'm here today to show you a sound and vibrations experiment, Super One for Key Stage 2. And we're going to be exploring two different ways to demonstrate how sound is caused by vibrations. All you need is a tuning fork, a small container of water, a standing clamp, a piece of string, and a ping pong attached to the end of the string with just some black tape. To start this experiment, I would make a sound with this tuning fork simply by striking it on the side. I'm sure the children will absolutely love this part. Now we can hear a sound, but I'm sure the children just struggle to get their head around the concept of the vibrations. The tuning fork's moving too quickly for us to see it. Now this is where it gets really exciting. Get your children to get as close to the container of water as possible, as if they're going to have to really concentrate on something that's going to happen. Do exactly the same thing again to make the sound, then place the tuning fork straight into the water. And if they got their faces close enough, which I'm sure they did, they'd have a nice splash in their face. So as they couldn't see any vibrations when we just held the tuning fork up, the water is a really good representation of how sound is caused by vibrations. And that's a really good lead on to how particles and sound work. So a second experiment to demonstrate the same thing is with the ping pong on a string. So same concept again, strike the tuning fork and show the children that they can't actually see the vibrations, but watch what happens this time. And I think that extreme movement of the ping pong ball is a fantastic visual representation of how sound is caused by vibrations.